वेलकम टू बेसिक थियोरेपी। आज हम पढ़ेंगे मल्टीप्लिकेशन शॉर्टकट्स एंड सम बेसिक फॉर्मूले। इसका आपको इस्तेमाल जो कॉम्प्लेक्स कैलकुलेशंस होती है उसको इजीली और कम समय में करने में होगा। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो द फर्स्ट मल्टीप्लिकेशन शॉर्टकट दैट वी विल एड्रेस टूडे इज अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ। सो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ इज इन रिस्पेक्ट टू बोथ एडिशन एज वेल एज सब्ट्रैक्शन। फर्स्ट वी विल सी दिस रूल फॉर एडिशन। सो इट सेज दैट A cross B plus C, that is, if A multiplies the addition of B plus C, then A multiplies B, A multiplies C individually, and their addition is equivalent to the actual answer. So, let us see how we can apply this rule. So, if we are given a complex multiplication like 38 into 101, so if we go by traditional method, that is 101 into 38, then it is going to consume a lot of time and efforts, and there are also chances of getting mistakes. So we will use distributive law to save on time as well as efforts. So we will treat A as 38. So 38 will remain the same. Now we have to define B and C. So we can write 101 as 100 plus 1. Is it right? So we have B now, we have C, and we have A. Now using the distributive law, we can say that A multiplies B, that is A is 38 into 100, because 100 is our B, plus 38 into C. C is 1. So now we have 38 into 100, we have 3800. Plus 38 ones are 38, which is equal to 3838. As easy as that. So you can try similar one for 86 into 101. Give it a try and mention the answer in comment box below. Moving on. Now we will learn distributive law with respect to subtraction. In previous slide we learned it in terms of addition. Now, all the rules remain the same. There is only a difference of sign. So let us go through it. If A multiplies the difference between B and C, then A multiplies B and A multiplies C. And the difference between both the multiplication is your actual answer. So let us see an example. If you are asked to calculate 38 into 99. So address A as 38. Now we'll have to express 99 in terms of B minus C. So we can write it as 100 minus 1. So we'll say 38 into 100 minus 1, where A is 38, B is 100, and C is 1. So using distributive law, we can write A into B, that is 38 into 100 minus A, that is 38 into 1. So we have 3800 minus 38. Answer will be 2973. 3792 is the answer. Try for 386 into 99. Give it a try for this and comment the answer in the comment box below. Now that I was talking about multiplication shortcuts, I want to cover not only the basic ones but the advanced ones as well. So if you're preparing for competitive exams of higher level, so go through this, but if it's not relevant to you, you might skip this part. So for those who want to learn this, here we go. So multiplication of a number by 5 raised to n. So 5 raised to n means the number which can be expressed in the form of 5 raised to n. For example, if there is a number 975436 into 25. So here we can express 25 in terms of 5 raised to n, that is 5 raised to 2. 5 square is 25. So we can express it in the given form. Now if you want to carry out this multiplication by traditional method, you can, but it will consume a lot of time. So here is a shortcut. So since we expressed it in the form of 5 raised to n, we have n equal to 2. Now what you have to do is you have to add the number of zeros which resemble n. That is, here we have 2. So you have to add 2 zeros before the given number. So we have 9, 7, 5, 4, 3, 6. I repeat, since n is equal to 2, we have to add 2 zeros. Had n be equal to 3, then you'll have to add 3 zeros, and so on. So now that we have done the second step, the first step was identify the number which is in the 5 raised to n form. Then your second step is you have to see what your n equals to. Third step is add the number of zeros which equals to n. So now that we have added the number of zeros before this, now you have to divide this number by 2 raised to n. Here our n is equal to 2. So 9, 7, 5, 4, 3, 6, 0, 0 divided by 2 raised to 2, which is equal to 4. So we have to divide this number by 4. So let's perform the division now. On dividing, you can try it in your notebook to save on time. I have already divided the number and you will get 2, 4, 3, 8, 5, 9, 0, 0. So this is the number that you will get on multiplying this number, that is 975436 into 25, you will get 2,4,3,8,5,9,0,0. Check your answer. I will revise the steps for multiplication of a number by 5n once again. Step number 1 is to identify if the number getting multiplied is of the form 5 raised to n. If it is, you have to express it in the form of 5 raised to n. Second step will be identify n, what it equals to. Third step is add n zeros in front of the number that you want to multiply. Fourth step is you have to divide the number added by the zeros by 2 raised to n. Now here your n will be equal to step number 2, that is to what your zeros are equal to. And fifth step is perform the division. For practice, the example that you're supposed to do is 975436 into 625. Try it and mention your answers in the comment down below. Now here are some basic formulae which will help you ease your calculation and simplify them. So if you are given a very large number, you can divide it into form of A and B, either in the form of addition or subtraction, and then perform this formula for squaring and cubing. So let's go through them one by one, and you have to by heart this formula and use your logic to apply them. So all I can do is I'll introduce them to you and we'll see some applications. So here a plus b bracket square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. So this is in term of addition for two elements which are a and b. This is for subtraction, which is a minus b bracket square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now if there are three elements, that is a, b and c, then you can use this formula, which is a plus b plus c bracket square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 into bracket ab plus bc plus cf. Let us see our next slide. As I mentioned, you'll have to by heart the formula. So if a large number is given, you have to divide it into in the form of a and b, either addition or subtraction, and then you have to see where you can apply these formulae. They are nothing but the modification of each other. Like if you see the left hand side of this and left hand side of this is same, and 4ab is expressed as this, so nothing but modification. So you have to by heart. So you can pause the video and note this formula down. These are very important in terms of competitive examinations. There's another a square minus b square, a plus b, a minus b. This is the formula that you'll use most often in the calculations. So please by heart them and we'll see another set of formulae. So previously we discussed some formulas in terms of a and b for square. Now here are some of the set which are very important in terms of cubing. So the same process, large number, divide into a and b, if required a, b and c, and then you have to apply these formulae for calculating the cubes. So here is a formula for calculating the cube of a plus b individual cube with respect to addition. The same one is in respect to subtraction, and third one is when there are three elements, that is A, B and C. So go through them, by heart them, and we'll see some applications in our next slide. So here is a comprehension based on what we learned today, and I want you all to strictly use the formulas that I have mentioned and then solve it rather than going for by the traditional method. So attempt this in your notebook and then we'll see for the answers. So here are the answers to the comprehension that you just attempted. I'm really interested to know what is your score in this. So please comment down below your score and we'll move on to the solutions in detail of these comprehensions, since we discussed only the formulae and not how to apply them. So I'll help you out with the solutions in detail for each of the examples. So let's get started. As I mentioned, I'm your mentor. I'm just going to help you get there. So I'll help you with the arrangements and simplification. Calculations you'll do on your own. So here we'll express number 9999 in the form of B and C to perform distributive law. And this is going to be in terms of subtraction. So we have to express number 9999 in the form of B minus C. So we can express that as 10,000 minus 1. Now you have your A, which is 5793405. This is your A into B minus C will be 10,000 minus 1. This is your B, this is your C. Now perform the further simplification. Next. So the first step in such examples is to find 5 raised to n. That is number of the form 5 raised to n, which is 625 here. So we know that 5 raised to 4 is 625. So second step is n equal to 4. We have found out our n. Third step is to apply number of zeros before the number you are multiplying. So 8394780000, 4 zeros we have added. Now fourth step is to divide it by 2 raised to n. So here our n is equal to 4. So 2 raised to 4, which is equal to 16. The final step is, fifth step is to perform the division of 38394780000 divided by 16. And you'll get your answer. Moving on. Now here, if you observe, the number 313 and 287 are repeated. So 313 is nothing but 313 bracket square plus 287 bracket square. Here we will use the formula a square plus b square. Now we know that this a square plus b square, we know this term a square plus b square. Now we have a equal to 313 and b equal to 287. Putting this value in the above equation, we'll get 313 plus 287 bracket square minus 313 minus 287 bracket square, and this is equal to 2 times the value of a square plus b square. That is your answer. You can do the calculations and find the answer. Moving on. Now here we have to find nothing but the square of number 1605, that is 1605. We can express this number in the form of A and B as 1600 plus 5 and do the bracket square. So you can put the values in the formula treating this as A and B. So we have 1600 bracket square minus 2 times 1600 5 plus 5 square and do the calculations. That's all about it. So here we come to the end of today's lecture. I know it was quite brainy, but don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Also, I'll be clearing all the basic concepts related to maths, which will help you in competitive exams further. Still, if you have any doubts regarding today's lecture, comment down below and I'll try to make a video on it. So stay tuned. Thank you.